monsieur. I wonder should I see some.
Dick Van Dyke was probably one of the most famous talents emerging from the WDSU studios.
No? When I sing and I say, say bon, say bon.
He had a nightly comedy show, but would later go on to star in his own sitcom, even movies. But for the early years, programming from news, entertainment to children's shows, those were staples on Channel 6. Shows like Mrs. Muffin, The Midday Show, Midnight with Mel, Wayne Mack, Morgus the Magnificent.
See, I got a lot of chemicals here, and of course, I'm sorry about the place, but you know, cleanliness is next to nothingness.
WDSU welcomed in lots of notable talent to record or perform. Ray Charles cut one of his first recordings, Feeling Sad, at the WDSU studios on Royal Street.
The way I love you, darling, it's a sin.
Louis Armstrong even wowed the crowds through our cameras. And one of the last performers at our French Quarter location, famed pianist Ronnie Cole. You also had many local names that became household staples. Bob and Jan Carr, Terry Fletcherich, Alec Gifford, for who our newsroom is named. Nash Roberts, also a guiding light for so many during storm season. The station also strived to become a beacon of information and hope through many seasons.
For happiness, hope, and dream.
And as faces still come and go from our set, the stories and rich history of WDSU will always remain the same.